Hi developers! For anyone that have been viewing my TwinCAT 3 tutorial here on YouTube, you may have noticed that it's not that obvious to get TwinCAT 3 to run on your desktop machine, be it directly on the machine or inside a virtual machine. The primary reason for this is because TwinCAT 3 is running in something called kernel space. TwinCAT 3 needs to run in kernel space so that it has direct access to the computer's resources, so that it can guarantee real-time performance. This is critical for the actual PLC that we will deploy on the machines we're building, but matters less while we do our actual development on our desktop. While we are developing software on our desktop, we usually want to test that the business logic of our software is sound and care less of stuff like cycle times and jitter. In the TwinCAT 3 tutorial, I had a special part that described the changes you need to do in your computer's BIOS and in the virtual machine, stuff like core isolation, etc., in order for you to run the software on your desktop. If we only could run TwinCAT in user space, just like any other process in the operating system, we as developers could be up and running much quicker. While I was bored recently on a Saturday late afternoon, I discovered that Beckhoff had quietly added some files in the TwinCAT 3 folder in one of the newer releases of TwinCAT 3. That might change all of this. How, you may wonder? Let's look at it together.
Okay, so what I got here is a completely fresh and new virtual machine. I've created a Windows 10 machine using VirtualBox and with a fresh and clean install of the TwinCAT XAE. So the version of the TwinCAT XAE I'm using is 4024.22. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is to show you how to enable this new user space functionality of TwinCAT. And you go to your C drive, TwinCAT 3.1, runtimes, and here you got some new folders that weren't here before. So UM something, I don't know what UM stands for, user mode maybe, I guess. And we can already notice we have a README here, and I encourage you to read it, but it basically says that this is a beta software by Beckhoff, and it's a beta and test version and pre-release, so it does not represent the final product. It may have functions limited in features, blah, 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 provided to as is for internal demonstration and test purposes, and no warranties expressed. Yeah, it's just as not suitable or intended for use in productive and commercial applications. And the use of the beta software is at your own risk. Yeah, just stuff you would expect. So it's clearly that this is a beta. Hopefully this message will be gone soon in a future release of TwinCAT 3. And here we have this folder with a batch file. So it's just a batch file that we can run, and this effectively starts the user space TwinCAT 3. And if we just not start it quite yet, but just create a new project, then and look how the system behaves before we start this one. So I'm just starting TwinCAT 3, the XAE. Let's just create a new project. Let's call it test TwinCAT user space. Okay, create a new PLC project. Now, this machine is a virtual machine. I created it with using, let's see here, 4 cores, if I remember it correctly. Yep, 4 cores. So if you try to run this guy now, it's not gonna work. We're gonna get the classical error when we're trying to run it in a virtual machine. So if you read from target, so target in this case is localhost, so the local PLC runtime, we get the classical 4 cores here. And if I try to activate the configuration, so let's just create a simple program that does the classical counter, just so that we know that the program is being executed. Like so, and let's try to activate this guy. Then we get the error message that setting TwinCAT in run mode on shared cores inside VirtualBox is not possible. So we know this, and the workaround for this is that we have to do the core isolation. So we have to do set one isolated core, put the isolated core as the one we want to run our task in, and we need to set on target and set one isolated core where we can run. Yeah, it's all this stuff that's always a little extra work that we want to avoid. Now we can try to run this user space TwinCAT instead. So effectively how you achieve that is that you want to execute this batch file. So we start a new command prompt, run as administrator. Let's go to this folder. So we got the bat file there, we just start it. And here we can see some interesting things happening. So it actually says it creates a system service for TwinCAT with a specific AMS NAT ID. So this AMS NAT ID is something you can change here. It's different from the one that we already have in the system. So if you look at the AMS NAT ID in the system right now, it's something different, which means we can have these two parallel concurrently with each other. And we can see this TCSys server UM, so user mode TwinCAT started. And we can restart it, and we can put it into config mode. So restart it means to set it into run mode if it's already in run mode. And then S is to view current state. So if I, and X to exit. So if I press S now, then yeah, we see, okay, we're in config mode. And we also see the AMS router memory, you know, this the stuff that we have here normally. So where is it? I think it's here. Yeah, this stuff. It's also available. So it seems it's allocating this separately from the normal TwinCAT. Very convenient. But now the interesting thing here is that what if we go here, we suddenly have not just local, but also this user mode TwinCAT running. So you can select it. Okay, let's see. And read from target. And now we just get a single core that's shared. I mean, this one is anyway running as a user space application. So it, I guess this, I don't know if this actually means anything, but we get a single core, which is fine because again, the purpose of this is when you usually just wanna run, you're developing software. This is, it's not important about real-time performance. You just want to run the software. You don't care about cycle times or jitter and cycle overruns. And And now it's actually just the only thing we need to do is to activate the application. Yeah, now it works. Restart TwinCAT in run mode. So I have not isolated any cores yet. So again, we still have four cores in the CPU as specified by the virtual machine. I haven't done any core isolation. All of this is visible to the user space, to Windows. So it's running in here. And now if I do a login, the application is running. So this is really fantastic. There's some other things I noticed you can do. So you can, again, you can restart the TwinCAT system. So you can, by pressing R, the runtime will, you see, it's restarting. You have a separate boot project for all of this. So this is installed here in the same folder in boot. So the whole TwinCAT application is installed in the specific folder. So you have your current config, the PLC, and the normal stuff that you would expect from the PLC application if it was running in kernel mode as well. So you even have the auto start flag here. So you can see if I delete it, if I remove the auto start flag, it's actually removed from, it was deleted. Now I can add it back. So everything is isolated in here. So yeah, it seems Beckhoff are onto something really, really interesting. And I'm sure I will use this a lot, and I would expect most TwinCAT developers will get use of this new functionality. There's some other things here as well. I mean, you can restart it, view the current state, and then you can put it in config mode. So if I press C, it goes into config mode, which Yeah, so now we're in config mode. You see the blue guy is here. We can check the state, config mode, and we can restart. So again, R, then it's running again. And I mean, I notice, if you notice that it's really, really quick. It's much, much quicker to switch between config and run mode compared to if you were running this on an isolated core in kernel mode. And you can, of course, quit this application by pressing X, stop, then it's died. And then this guy disappears, so it's gone. The user space TwinCAT runtime. So good job, Beckhoff. I'm really looking forward for the formal release of this.
It seems that Beckhoff are simply preparing this functionality for a full and formal release in the future. Maybe some of Beckhoff's customers have asked for this, and that's why Beckhoff added it as a beta feature before rolling it out more widely. No idea. My guess is that this will be formally released in the next major release of TwinCAT 3, so 3.1.4026. But only time will tell. In either way, this is a great feature that I'm sure that almost every single TwinCAT 3 developer on the planet will use, so I hope it's released as soon as possible. It's not just good for running ordinary PLC logic, it's also very useful for running unit tests written in TCUnit that up until now also required you to do core isolation on virtual machines. Indeed, great times ahead of us. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you like the content, please hit like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.